The tranquil beauty of Palo Duro Canyon State Park is magnificent. Located just south of Amarillo and called the Grand Canyon of Texas, Palo Duro Canyon is second in size only to the Grand Canyon. The flat plains of Texas Panhandle open up unexpectedly to wondrous Palo Duro Canyon. It cuts a 130-mile path through the prairie. That's up to 20 miles wide and a mile deep. Filled with flowers and wildlife, Palo Duro Canyon is a camper's dream and a photographer's paradise. Petroglyphs, carving into stone surfaces and ancient campsites, help to tell the story of those who came to Palo Duro first. The canyon provided protection for the elements, a source of fresh water, buffalo, and other game close at hand. So it was a stronghold to many. As he led his entourage across the high plains in 1540, Francisco Vasquez de Coronado wrote, "I traveled until I reached some plains with no more landmarks than as if we had been swallowed by the sea." Coronado is credited for naming the Palo Duro region Llano Estacado, or the Staked Plains. Legend has it that the conquistadors used stakes to mark their route through the endless sea of grass so as not to lose their way, and it is said that the flared formations of Palo Duro were given the name Spanish Skirts by Coronado's homesick men missing the women they had left back home in Spain. 12,000 years of Indian rule ended in 1874. It was then that Colonel Randall Bad Hand McKenzie led the U.S. troops searching out Indian villages, destroying all that was in their path.
Back in September of 1874, there was a combined village of Kiowa, Comanche, and Southern Cheyenne Indians, always wintered in this canyon. They did because there's always water here. Where there's water, there's wildlife. And that north wall protected them from the winter winds. Well, there was a battle up at Adobe Walls. And after that battle, the man in charge of the army, a guy by the name of General Sheridan, a little upset. So he sent a Lieutenant Colonel Randall Slidell McKenzie and the 4th Cavalry down here with orders to kill the Indians. Well, McKenzie went down into South Texas and he hired some Tonkawa Indian scouts. Those Tonkawa came up here and tracked the Comanche to this canyon. They led McKenzie and the 4th Cavalry here just after sundown on September 26, 1874. McKenzie's men started looking for a way down into the canyon. They finally found a buffalo trail that wound down the wall of the canyon, and one of these cavalrymen shot and killed an Indian lookout just about sunrise. They gathered up 1,400 head of Indian horses. They drove those horses back through the village, burned the Indians' teepees and winter supplies. And then McKenzie had his men drive those horses up out of the canyon. He gave about 400 head of horses to his Tonkawa Indian scouts and sent them home. Had his men drive the remaining 1,000 head of horses about 30 miles south of here to a place called Tule Canyon, where he had his men shoot and kill those 1,000 horses. Now, they say that on a quiet fall evening, just after sundown, sometimes if you listen carefully, you'll hear what sounds like a herd of horses running through this canyon. They say that's the ghost herd of Indian horses that come back and run this canyon looking for that thing.
A new century dawned. People in the nearby town of Canyon made Sunday excursions to Palo Duro. It became a favorite spot for college students, In 1917, just out of college and on her first teaching assignment at West Texas Normal College, Miss Georgia O'Keeffe was a frequent canyon visitor, and it served as an early influence to her renowned artwork. She once stated, "Palo Duro is a burning, seething cauldron filled with dramatic color and light." The showpiece of Palo Duro is the lighthouse, rising 300 feet above the canyon floor. This pinnacle rock can be seen from the rim. Triassic Peak, which towers above the riding stables, shows three of the canyon's four major geological formations. Capitol Peak with its hoodoo on the left, Fortress Cliff, the Rock Garden, the Devil's Slide, and ranging from less than an inch upward to 100 feet, pedestal rocks or balance rocks are a unique and familiar part of the landscape. Winter snows and spring rains are enough to make the canyon come alive with color. Even in the hot, dry environment of West Texas, flowers flourish. From the early spring until late frost, flowers abound and play an important part of the ecosystem. The yucca are food for the deer. The flowers feed all manner of insects. And so the cycle goes. No matter what the season, winter, spring, summer, or autumn, Palo Duro Canyon always has something surprising and beautiful waiting just around the corner.